Okay, so we got the go-ahead from the client to attempt to repair and get it going. So what I would like to do is have a look on the power, our power supply, see how many amps it takes. Okay. Of course, we need 19 volts for this model. Volts, 3 amps. Okay. Off. On. Off. Okay, let's check. And power on. So it doesn't take any amps. 0.01. Okay. So this board will not turn on, yeah? That's the issue. This one will need a full cleanup as well. Okay. Hopefully it's a simple fix. Like, look at the BIOS, they put it right over there. It's crazy. Okay. So DC jack runs under the left speaker, okay. Well, with this, just speed it up a little bit. I will look at if there is any immediate shorts around any of the coils. Resistance. That's the ground we can use. Yes, okay. Really? Oh, fuck me then. Okay. Big problem. That's a big problem. Hello, is SureCan speaking? Okay. One problem. We don't know if that's normal. That's not normal. Okay. Okay, I need to get my brain back together. So this here 0.086 is a cable resistance. To ground here, another 0.1 on top. Here, we may be fine. I don't think it's a dead short. And that is the GPU, so you know, it could be, it is usually less ohms than the CPU. So I'm gonna say we're okay for now. We already checked that in this one. Okay. Those low numbers scare me. Could be bad CPU, I don't know. Looks like the chipset is there. Okay, let's see in this mode, or I can't. I've got a jumper on a jumper wire, okay. So let's just have a look at this board on the microscope, see if anything obvious will pop up. And we'll do a quick testing of the MOSFETs. See how we go. Have a look in diode mode. Give me one sec. Okay, let's have a look under the microscope, see if anything pops up there. Start from the bottom corner, which is pretty much nothing. So basically it turns on and nothing happens. That's the issue. see if these guys are okay. Yeah, they're fine. Now these are the 3-volt, 5-volt rail normally. You can tell by Is that a coil? Okay, let me get this straight. Okay, so a bit weird here and here. Okay, so we do have a dead short. Okay, good. Yeah. Oh, good. Okay. How come I didn't pick it up earlier? Yeah, this is a dead short. Okay. Yay, finally we have an easy one. So it could be one of these three guys. So he's saying short, he's saying short, he's saying short. So which one is short? We're going to use an ESR meter. See if I can find the short using this guy. So, cables earn resistance 1.05. So that's a 0.1. That one looks dead short. How about the other one there? This one is lower. This one. A very hard one to measure. Very hard one to pick, so I'm gonna take a poke. We can inject one volt, see what happens. It wouldn't hurt. But there's only three caps there, no need to. Let's try him first. Do we still have a short? Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. Maybe it's not the caps. I should have just removed the coil. Okay. It's somewhere else. It is not here. You know what? One of the fans on YouTube said, why don't you use your power supply? Yeah, why not? Let's give it a go. Let's try. We're going to do 1 volt and 1 amp. Okay. Okay. Power is currently off. And if I power it on, see if you can. Here we go. Power on. So whatever it is taking amps, okay? And we don't know what it is yet, but we'll bring the thermal cam. Hope it's not a 3-volt rail and the PCH is dead or something like that. I just hope it will be something simple. All right, give me one sec. All right. Has this motherboard cooled down a little bit? Okay, let's see if we do see anything like this. Okay, let's power on. Amps. Okay. Just poke around the board. Okay, maybe something on that side. Let's cut the power. Power is off. Okay. Let's turn the board around. All right. Let's power it on again. Nothing. Okay. This may be not good. Could be a reflection. Okay. Don't know. So what I'm gonna do is actually take the CPU. Out, and the fan module out, because we're gonna give it a clean anyway. Maybe removing them can reveal some other information. Better take this out safely. Okay. Let's go back to power injection. Okay, let's go minimal information. Okay, let's go. Power. On. Nothing is being taken. Double check the wiring. Oh, Okay, so I was injecting power to the CPU then. It's kind of odd, isn't it? See if the short is still there. Turn off the power. And continuity. But we still have a... Is it a partial short? Check his resistance. That is to the CPU. Okay. So if we check that one more time to here, reading 0.08 when the CPU is removed. What, we have a dead CPU? I never came across a dead CPU. Put the CPU back in. I've locked it in. And .05. That's fine. So that means our CPU is good. Okay. With the power injection, we're barking at the wrong tree. Alright, this is not a shorted guy issue. It is not a shorted power rail. Okay. It looked like it was a buck converter next to it for 3.3. But I'm wrong. Okay. Okay. So let's have a look which power rails are present when we apply power. So let's put that jump wire on the 12 volt, 19 volt line, and then we can inject power, and we haven't got the DC jack. It's on the other board, and I don't want to take out the I don't want to take out the speaker. Okay, so we've got 19 volts power currently on. Okay, voltage mode. The board is actually trying to start. See that behavior? Yep, give me a sec. Okay, so I'm back and we've got 19 volts in the system, but we're looking for the coils which may have the 5 volt and 3 volt. Anything here? Nothing. You see that? Something's happening to these coils. It's trying to turn on, but it's failing. That's why the multimeter is the benchtop power supply going 0.01 amps and then off. Can't get any. That is very unusual voltage. It doesn't stay up. This indicates a problem. I'd like to see this behavior on the thermal cam. Okay, power is off. Okay, now I'm going to leave the power on and let's just look at this behavior. Like a dot appearing there and going. That's the GPU we're looking at. Keep going. do know that coil is starting up and shutting down. Or it's not in a happy stage. Okay, I'm going to turn the board around. We need a different ground now. What's the voltage on that? Let me check. I think I may need to use an oscilloscope. A bit tricky. So what I normally look for, if you're wondering, the pulsating behavior on the side. Like if you look at that, this guy here, you see the voltage pulsating jumping up and down on the right side more often. So it's either something along those lines or we rotate the board all the way around this one. Sure. Okay, so we've been checking temperatures here, there, everywhere, and I think either this guy or this guy's power rail, something not right. So what I'm gonna do, we cut the power and check resistance. It was that one and that one. So this looks like 3.3 volts. There's a MOSFET there. Why don't we just check the MOSFET? We're in DC mode. Let's check resistance mode. Well, that's for a battery. Why will that be going mental? Or it's maybe it's not. Okay, let me have a look properly. Gate to drain. Okay, my probes are not working. They are working. Try again. Okay, gate to drain, nothing. Oh well. Gate to source, kilo ohms. Source to drain. Okay. Gate to source. Gate to drain. And gate to drain. Okay. High side or low side, maybe? They put this jumper so we can isolate. Ten kilo ohms. 1.9 mega. And the other side. Ohms, okay. Gate to ground. This is a drain to ground, source to ground, gate to ground. See if I can find the schematics for this board. And 76V. Let's have a look. And let's have a look on the ESR forum, see if anyone has... Hey, buddy! Oh my god! Who bring... Did Santa bring it? Okay. Oh, thank you, Harry. I'll put that away. You're a good boy.
I can carry heavier.
You're growing up, aren't you? Oh, okay, I'll put it away. Thank you, Harry. Hey! Look at your hair! What is it? Oh my god, Hannah, you're growing up, man. You're here now. Yeah, or not. Oh, that's for talking. See? Blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Okay. See ya. Okay. Yes, I have. Okay, so someone has a similar problem. Their one turns on and then turns off. Let me see what they said to him. Maxi, back in December 2021. Wow, very recent. Okay, and how about someone requesting a schematic, so board view, did he get it? Oh yeah, thank you so much. There's even a repair guide for this, okay, beautiful. So we got a board view, so we have no reason why we can't fix this now. Okay, let's have a look. Okay, so we've got some measurements, thankfully, to somebody. Probably Sua Laptop 365 edu.vn, a website. Okay, so what they've told us, what they've given us, VCC, LSVO, no, we're interested in higher voltages. Let me see where they are. PM sub, PM all system power good, U303. Okay, so U303, which is that guy there. Okay, so we need to investigate this now properly. Let's go into voltage mode. We need to plug power. And we got 19 volts. Power is, let's turn on the power. Power is on. Okay, so what do we get reading for? Here. It's coming and going. It is not staying stable. How about the 19 volts? Is it staying stable? Yes, it is. Okay. So it's jumping up and down. Okay, so we can now find our 3.3 and 5 volt always on rails through. It says we should be able to detect that somewhere. Okay, I think it may be here. Yeah, so this is 5 volt always online, and this is 3.3 always online. Okay. Yeah, it's a very interesting problem. So it's all like coming in, going out, coming in. So it's like it can't stay on. Why? BQ24725. Okay, let's have a look at that chip here. It's a long video, this one, far out. Yeah, that's our BQ chip. Just need to be careful, this crazy 19 volts. Okay, number one is the ACN. It's not staying up. A really weird setup. Like, this is not acceptable. Wow, this is so weird. Okay, let's cut the power. We have no power in the board. And just check for... So pin number 14 is the only ground. And 14 is on the left. Basically power coming in, cutting out, cutting in, cutting out, cutting in, cutting out. How about pin number 5? If you plug the power back in. Voltage mode. Pin number 5 says power okay, which is here. It's like okay, not okay, okay, not okay. Look, it wouldn't hurt to replace this guy, yeah? Let's do that. BQ25A. This is the older one. I think I might have plenty of these. Let me check. Yeah, I've got 15 of them. Jesus, okay. interesting layout of a chip. Is that the right location? Nah. Shit. It's number. I got 15 in on location 23. Here we go. So we don't even know if this is the issue because it's very temperamental. Now one thing I would like to check is inject power again and check for voltage on AC. And see if it keep cutting out. Okay, so power is currently on for voltage mode. Yes, the rest of the board doesn't have any power, obviously. Nothing is going to happen. And pin number 20, which is the bottom here, is going to be the charger voltage. Okay. Maybe not wise to have power on. Okay, we cut the power. Okay. Okay. Let's bring in the new chip. All right, here we go. Okay, he's in. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead, inject power shortly, wait for it to cool down a little bit more. Okay, power on, and it's the same behavior. Wait a minute. Have you got 19 volts? Where is 19 volts coming in? Let's go back and follow the 19 volt power rail. Okay, charger AC detect should be coming in to what's the voltages here? Okay, that's a bit weird. Okay, AV adapter dock in should come here. Okay, I think problem may go all the way to here, which should be coming in to there. Okay, I think we're getting to the source of the problem. Okay. Okay. And these guys should be straight 19 volts, which we don't have. Okay. All right. We still don't have our 19 volts, far out. Okay, we have to keep chasing it. What the hell? Or is there 19 volts? What am I doing? Am I in voltage mode? Yeah. I've got ground. Let me double check my ground. Is there shit ground? Oh man. Okay, 19 volts is there. Okay, 19 volts is here. Nah, this is not good. The gate is jumping up and down. Okay, okay. I think I need to start from beginning. Find out where the hell is my 19 volts. Okay, let's start from beginning. Okay, my 19 volts is there. Comes into here. Okay. That's the first thing. And then from there, that's the voltage DC jack, okay? It goes to the other side. Okay, let's go to the other side now. We have this weird partial short-like behavior on the main 19 volts rail. Okay. Okay, so it comes into these capacitors, which are they're on the this cover here. Okay, let's see. Okay, 19 volts come through. This is PJP, so this is the jumper, if you like. Yeah, correct. And goes through the resistor and goes to this capacitor, which is there. Okay. Okay, and then it jumps over to the other side, over here. And then from there it jumps to this voltage divider, which is which is under the coil there. So that's where it comes to 19 volts or the battery voltage, whichever is higher, and that gets through, goes to this guy, and it goes to here. Okay, and from there, where do you go? Emitter. I will look on the other side now. Okay, here we are. Okay, let's go to the other side of the board. We're slowly getting close to that. To that area. Oh, Okay, so it should be on the left side, somewhere here. So this resistor should have... Okay, let me double check. And I'm looking at the right stuff. Now this one here should have the 19 volts, which we do. It's jumping up and down. Okay, so from there, on the right side, from here, all the way to here, we should have the same voltage. Okay, finally. Okay. Because I didn't have the ground properly before, that's why I was messing around. PU8802. This is a problem. I need to isolate the power rails. Okay, RT-826A. Oh my God, I'm having a headache. Okay. Okay. Okay, we have a power on sequence. Okay, let's have a look at number one. Okay, 5 volt always online and 3 volt always online. And then ECRST hash. Okay. 5 volt always online. Let's find out. Okay. Okay, so I know where it is. Let's go and find it. Quite a far place. Okay, somewhere here. This guy, PU2100, is what generates Richtek RT8239B. This guy's very... Okay, we got the sound back. So basically 5 volts and 3 volts, they're all coming from this tiny little guy. Now I'm going to check for continuity for shorts or something like that on this chip. Okay, nothing absolutely ground on this. Except the bottom. Now this guy needs to get voltage in so you can make the voltages. Now there is a, look, let me just cut that power, right? I'm just thinking, what will happen if I just remove this jumper? This will, technically, yeah. 5 volt always on. We'll eliminate that just for testing. So just check there should be no continuity. If we did separate that correctly. Good. And let's see what happens to the power when we plug it in. And all switch. All microscope. Power is currently on, and I'm going to connect the cable. Same behavior. So it's not a problem with our 5 volt rail. We can eliminate that. Okay. Okay. Now let's fix that connection again. Now let's look for the 3.3 volt. There is the hall sensor. Let's switch, I'm not interested. Okay, one sec. Currently searching for 3 volt line jumper, PJP, battery connection, no. Come on. So many jumper points, far out, except the one I want, come on. .302, nope. 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 .201, nope. .200. Nope. 106, okay, got it. Okay, 3 volt all on to 3 volt suspend. Okay. This guy is. We're looking at the right area. It's this guy here. Okay, let's eliminate him. Take him out. See if there is a continuity. There is no power in the system. Okay, let's plug in the power. Power is already on, so I'm just gonna connect the cable. Same scenario. Okay, so the problem is not there. Let's disconnect the power and put this guy back in. Okay, another one. Give me another one. We already checked that one. How about this one? Voltage in. I already checked that one. Okay, there's one more. On the north of that guy there. This one says P underscore 5 volt, 3 volt voltage in standby, or S. I have no idea. Clean and power. same scenario. So what else can be causing this problem? I mean, could it be that this chip is bad? It's a bad assumption to make. I have no reason to suspect it. Put some alcohol there. You know, if you look real carefully, you can see a heartbeat there. Look. There's a pulsating behavior. I don't know if you can pay attention, if you can see it. Here we go. Look carefully, you will see a pulsating behavior. See that? That. The chip is, heart is beating. That's fucking funny. Okay. Wow. Okay. FJ. FJ equals to no, is that an EQ? JC. JC equals to FA. So this is an RT808239. No, I haven't got this. Pin number 11 is voltage in, as per schematics. In that case, let me check the voltage. make sure I'm looking at the right chip. No. Pin number 11 there. Okay, voltage in. Pin number 11. I was about to go for the wrong chip. Power is currently in the board and we're in DC mode. 11, I believe it's this one. What? Here we're getting nothing. Yeah, it's jumping. Doesn't stay up. Something's not right. Something is playing up on this motherboard. But I don't know what is. It should be 5 volts. Okay. But it's not 5 volts. So the question is, what will happen if we put 5 volts there? Let's cut the power. I'll make sure not to put 20 volts, so I'll just change the voltage. Let's just say 1 volt, 1 amp, okay? Alright. Let's put a jumper wire there. Let's put 1 volt there. So we got 1 volt in there and nothing happening. Okay, disconnect power. Let's go 2 volts. No, not yet. I haven't got power in there. That's okay. 0, 2. There we go. 2 volts. Plug in the power. Nothing. Disconnect. Nothing. 3.23. Nothing. 3.84. Nothing. Okay, here we go. 4.85. 4.46. Nothing. So whatever is giving power, so I don't think there's an issue with this. Okay, let's make that 5 volts. Clean 5 volts, and there we go. Which is fine, just 0.01, okay. Now we don't have a problem on this power rail at all, we're fine. Alright, I'm gonna call it a day for now. Call this part one horrible. Okay, see you in the next one.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to support this channel.